Kenya's independence in 1963, the founding father, Mzee Jomo Kenyatta, declared that poverty, disease, and ignorance, due to largely an educated population, were Kenya's main development challenges. The government of the young budding nation had to urgently and aggressively institute and pursue several policies and strategies with the aim of alleviating poverty and spurring economic growth that would in turn realize national prosperity. These included industrialization, rural development, housing and health and education programs. Subsequently, in its election manifesto of 1963, the new government identified education as one of its key pillars for economic development and growth, and henceforth committed itself to bring social change through education. And as education and skills development for qualified human resource workforce got pace, there was a dire need for cross-border knowledge sharing and to diversify socio-economic reference resource materials. The idea of libraries as centers for information in Kenya's major towns was becoming a reality and a key need towards empowering Kenyans with knowledge and appropriate information and kicking out ignorance that was a main contributor of poverty and disease.
The library helped me quite a lot because I was able to get the books and increase my knowledge, knowing that it is I saw education as my savior from my cultural bondage.
The legislative leaders and the policymakers of the independent Kenyan Republic then crafted an Act of Parliament in 1965 to establish the Kenyan National Library Service, whose core functions include promotion, establishment, equipping, managing, and maintaining the national and public library services in Kenya, enhancing stakeholders' participation for equitable development of libraries throughout the country, and advising the national government, county governments, and other public bodies on all matters relating to library, documentation, and related services.
It became operational in 1967 when the first ever public library was opened to the public. The development strategy then was to cover all the erstwhile provincial regions.
The earliest public library in Kenya was a Saif bin Salim public library. Asian philanthropists established this library to cater for the information needs of the Asian community. Asians, and in particular the Indians, were brought into Kenya in their thousands to assist in the construction of the Kenya-Uganda Railway, which started in Mombasa in 1898.
It was started in 1903 at the old town. It moved to the current building in 1957 when it was officially opened. And Kenya National Library Service took over in 1978.
Other libraries established between 1910 and 1932 included Kenya National Assembly Library, National Museum Library, Macmillan Memorial Library, National Public Health Library, Attorney General's Library, and Kenya Agricultural Research Institute Kari Library.
Any publication, any book written in and about Kenya, the National Library of Kenya has to have a custody.
The successive governments of post-independent Kenya worked tirelessly to improve the education sector. Apart from appointing the KNLS boards, they have been offering valued support to KNLS. President Moi's administration ensured development of schools all over, while President Kibaki is known for free primary school education, and President Uhuru is bringing ICT into education from an early age of schooling. Kenyan National Library Service, referred to as KNLS in short, has had and continues to play a great role in all facets of national development through the support they offer to the education sector. It is an irrefutable fact that Kenya, through such well-founded initiatives, has built a very strong human resource base, be it in engineering, tourism, agriculture, business management, health, or in information technologies development, commonly referred to as ICT.
How do you develop without knowledge? How do you develop, say, the health sector without doctors? How do you develop the doctors without the right information, without the right resource? And the library provides that resource.
In its service provision, Kenyan National Library Service plays a dual role of public library and National Library of Kenya. The public library services are available in their 60 branches spread within Kenya among them numerous community libraries. On the other hand, the National Library Services are available at the headquarters in Nairobi and offer the following services. Preservation of the national imprint through the collection and safe custody of legal deposits of Kenyan publications, production of the national bibliography, issuance of the International Standard Book Number ISBN and the International Standard Music Number ISMN, provision of reference and referral services, provision of online database to researchers, stocking of specialized collections as well as specialized government publications such as Laws of Kenya, Kenya Gazettes, and bound copies of past newspapers, and acts as a development information center for the World Bank. The public libraries offer book lending, library advisory services, technical assistance on library development to interested government and private institutions.
Most primary schools could not access books. The teachers could not access books. People who learn distant learning could not access books. But with the introduction of this library here, people are very comfortable. Those who want to learn at home have registered here, they have become members. They can pick the books, read at their own disposal.
I have had an association which I appreciate very much with the Kenya National Library Service since the late 80s, for I was able to educate myself and sit for my accounting papers, and it helped me in my pursuit of knowing something about everything and everything about something.
KNLS and Ministry of Agriculture through National Farmers Information Service, NAFIS, has made it possible for farmers to access online information services and extension officers who respond to any of their queries regarding farming activities.
Library yetu ilipojengwa hapa ambayo inaitwa Mary Pash Memorial Library nianza kujiunga na hiyo library. Sasa nikapata pale kuna journals pale nikasoma yeye nikaona kuna mradi ya kilimo pale baada ya ufugaji wa ng'ombe na ufugaji wa sungura. Sasa hivi vile mimi mtu wa kilimo nimeongeza mapato yangu nilipoanza kutumia mbinu mpya za kilimo.
Health workers are making good use of the Kenyan National Library Service e-health corners for research and study and to seek information about treatment of illnesses. They are also able to interact with their colleagues all over the world and share new information on emerging diseases or researches on medicine and treatments.
I've accumulated tremendous amounts of data to answer some of the questions, because scientists know a lot of stuff that can benefit even the health system, teach, inform policy.
Having realized from the beginning that the Kenyan community is diverse, Kenyan National Library Service, as an equal services provider, introduced services also for the physically challenged. They started services to the blind in October 1996. KNLS believes in empowering the challenged persons to enable them to join other Kenyans in national development.
It is through this section that we serve the visually impaired learners of all categories, right from nursery up to the university. So it actually helps the visually impaired learners access the education and compete effectively against their sighted peers.
You have reached the end of the book. Next section.
I've been coming here severally, in fact, since 2010, I can say so. And I've been getting more knowledge through these books and making my braille skill not to disappear or not to fade away.
Our partner, Kenya National Library, has really helped us to ensure that the students pass their exams. Our candidates have done very well over the years. In fact, last year, our standard 8 managed to get the first candidate at 394. In form 4, they have equally done very well. In fact, last year, we got A-, and that candidate is now doing a Bachelor of Medicine and Surgeon in Nairobi University, and several of us have done very well.
Myself, I'm just doing accounts, and I just stood a library where I read, because I don't have a teacher, I don't, so it is, I just pick the books and then I go on. And then I got a sponsor, he registered me, I do exam, I pass, I continue. So you see, library has played a major role in just eradicating illiteracy and also bringing a future for those who are thinking that prison can just shatter your future, but it can just open your future.
In the larger Meru County, on the slopes of the beautiful Mount Kenya, apart from the regular traditional services, the personnel has innovatively decided to take the library literally to the villages, walking several kilometers in rural terrain. Among those they visit on a weekly basis is a group of mentally challenged children living with a condition known as autism. Every week, they take to these children the 30 electronic tablets donated through Book Aid International.
Misi kuwa na imagine wanaweza watolea fitu kama tablet, wakawatolea ni fitu expensive, na unaona hawa watoto wanaruka-ruka, wakona hyper wengine, wakaanza kuwafundisha, wengine wameshika, wamejua hata kuzioperate.
And as the sun sets on the slopes of Mount Kenya, the race is on to reach another group of challenged children, the deaf children of Kahaga Primary School. A group of 30 deaf students are being taught how to use tablets to solve mathematical problems or other science subjects.
I've seen them learning how to do computation skill with the tablets, addition, subtraction, and painting. I saw them painting pictures.
As they wind up the lesson, a temptation to take each other's photos is simply irresistible. Click and the image is stored until next time. But Meru is not the only place where children are on the tabs. These are the generation of kids on the tab. The Kibera Tablet Computers Project is the first of its kind to be offered by Kenya National Library Service. Launched in 2012 with funding support from the Electronic Information for Libraries, EIFL, it is being implemented in partnership with the educational agency Elimu Kenya, Practical Action, and the National Library Service. This internet-connected tablet computers have been preloaded with educational content linked to the National Education Curriculum to help children living in Kibera, the largest slum in East and Central Africa, improve their school results.
This library has helped me a lot because I knew how to use a tablet, and then I did my homework well with my friends. We discussed some our homework. We would use the tablets to Google and get the answers that we needed. And in KCP it was easier, and I got my 4-4.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Can you sit?
Children have really been encouraged to go to the book, to the library, by the tablets, because it's like some of them tend to go there and use those tablets, but at the end of it all, they even go ahead and now do the reading.
The children have improved in English, which has also affected the other subject to improve. Children who did their KCP in the year 2013, whom we started training with the tablets in the year 2012, majority of those children have gone to provincial and others to national schools, and many of them, they got over 350 marks.
It is important that our children keep up, and even adults, with the modern technology. The e-reader, instead of having books in the bookshelves, one e-reader is holding about 3,000 books. You have that tablet and you are a working library.
In an effort to expand library services to all citizens, KNLS partners with communities to develop libraries in these areas. The development of community libraries is governed by the Community Library Development Policy and funded by the community and the Constituency Development Fund, CDF.
there was need to increase the number of space available for people to read. The library became small and congested. The Kenya National Library and the community came up and we solicited for funds. In fact, we were even given funds through the local CDF. The National Library contributed some funds and the CDF also contributed part, and we put up a magnificent building which you can see around.
We find ourselves in a basin. We don't know what's happening beyond the hills of Marakwet. Neither do we know what's happening beyond the hills of Pokot on the other side. And we are killing each other like chicken, pecking on one another, because we didn't know anything better. But now with the Peace Library, a Pokot child will come there seek knowledge. The Lagan Peace Library has brought in something unique that if I want to access the internet, I will come. So it's not only for students. It is really bringing us together, even the elites, to come there and see even what is the latest book to read.
Communities all over Kenya are also encouraged to establish libraries in memory and honor of their loved ones. So far, several such libraries have been developed, among them Mary Patch Turnbull Memorial Library in Weruga in Taita Taveta County, Dr. Robert Ouko Community Memorial Library in Koru, Kisumu County, and Kibra Library, an initiative of Barclay family, who chose to honor their son Alistair Barclay, who died in the Lockerbie bombing. After the Libyan government compensated them, they chose to use the funds in establishing a library to assist the vulnerable communities.
We sent out a questionnaire out in the community to find out whether the idea was a good one or not. And the questionnaire came back with an overwhelming support for a need for a community library in this community. So we thought this was a befitting memorial for somebody who loved books and who loved to impart knowledge.
When I retired, I had to give all my books to Narok Library so that we encourage the Maasai to develop a culture of reading. If you go to Narok Library, there is a corner called Timama's Corner. It has got my picture and it has got all the books that I donated.
We are now in a new constitution. A new constitution. The public libraries is actually the function of counties. As they establish the new libraries, the KNLS, we are ready to give them any kind of advice that they may need, from technical advice and everything that we'll give them.
Education for all is a United Nations rallying call that no one in the modern world should remain uneducated in the 21st century and beyond. To this end, strategies exist from Kenya National Library Service to reach everyone wherever they are in Kenya, whether there are infrastructure or none. To achieve that, KNLS has invested innovatively in 4 mobile bus libraries in major towns. Unlike in other provincial libraries, KNLS was unable to offer motorized mobile libraries in northeastern part of Kenya due to poor roads, temporary settlements, and nomadic lifestyle of the communities. Camels, which are the predominant mode of transport in the region, offered a perfect alternative. Kenya National Library Service started offering the camel library services in Garissa in 1996 and 1999 in Wajir, operating in a radius of about 15 kilometers from the static libraries, and targeting school children, adult learners, social workers involved in various community initiatives, and retirees.
These are nomads, people who shift from one place to another. So sometimes you see that the child this time is in this school. Next time this place becomes drought and you see they start now shifting to another settlement.
In Murang'a and Karatina in central Kenya, National Library Service has opted for motorbikes that take book boxes to schools. The motorbike book box service is a collaborative effort between the branch libraries with schools. The goal of mobile library service in Kenya is to expand the library services to to inconvenienced user communities in both rural and urban areas,
so as to reach the small children such as the nursery school and the baby class. We've come up with a book made of cloth. The advantage of the book cloth is that it draws attention of the small children because of the colors, the pictures, and you can also wash the cloth, and it can be kept for quite some time.
Our policy is access. Make library accessible to Kenyans, whether physically or remotely. And I think there's a lot of mileage in emphasizing the element of digitization.
Kisumu Library covers the whole of Nyanza and due to American Corner, we have come up with programs that are covering the western part of Kenya and eastern part of Uganda. We have Google Plus, we have Skype, just to enable us to reach out to all these people.
This place has given us opportunities to nurture our talents in different ways, like drawing, singing, dancing, poetry, from the activities we like to communicate peace, love, and unity.
Read books, interact with the internet, so your souls can have wings. As our great poet said, if you're looking for people of stature, come to the library. If you're looking for people who don't have stature, come to the library. If you want to read about great women, great Kenyans, come to the library. If you want a place to meditate, come to the library.
Development of these libraries has been possible with the support of government grants, development partners, and in the community, where the community contributes buildings, and the local MPs through constituency development funds will refurbish the facilities, and KNLS will provide qualified librarians and stock the facilities with books and other modern digital library facilities.
For us, the Kenya National Library Service is a valued partner, and we provide a whole range of books, from Kenyan and African literature through to English literature through to practical manuals about agriculture, about health and well-being, and indeed about how to develop to the maximum the human capacity, the capacity that every single one of us has to do better and to be a better person.
Communication Authority of Kenya has assisted in the establishment of 10 e-resource centers in rural libraries within the KNLS network. Each of these centers have been equipped with a server, 10 computers, internet cabling, and connection.
We are happy to see an exponential growth in the use of the modern technologies, particularly the ICT technologies, by Kenyans. And for these reasons, we intend to ensure that through the Kenyan National Library Services outlets, they can also be able to act as community telecenters or ICT centers for where people can be able to access information from their portals.
With the e-resource centers in place, KNLS Muranga launched the basic ICT skills training in April 2013.
Those who graduated earlier, they have been employed in local cybers and photocopy services which are outside here. Also, we have those who are doing their research.
We are not able to meet our budget in terms of coming up with new products. So what we have done in the recent past is that we are embracing the partnership kind of development approach, because partners have different interests in different areas.
We have a product here at Laugh Industry called Kids Festival, where we bring children together from all walks of life to come and interact, read together and have fun. What we are trying to achieve between KNLS and Kids Festival was
trying to encourage reading from not a school environment, making reading cool.
For the last 5 years, KNLS has witnessed establishment of 13 libraries, modernization of 15 through automation, and refurbishment of 10 others across the country.
I call upon each one of you to embrace the culture of reading. If you don't read, then you are not in the right age. This is the age of information. Read and use the libraries very well. And with these remarks, it is my pleasant duty to declare this library officially open. Thank you very much.
But all this has not been without its challenges. With only 60 branches in various parts of the country, it is evident that a larger area is yet to be covered and reached. Those require cooperation of all the national and county governments, the legislative support, constituency development funds, communities, development partners, investors, and support from the various stakeholders.
Currently, Kawatina Community Library is very congested, housed in a very small building, which was formerly the maternity clinic. The aeration is not very ideal for a library, so there is that need for expansion.
The board has prioritized Vision 2030 as one of its key programs in terms of service delivery. What we have done at the moment, we have one major flagship project which we are implementing in Nairobi, a state-of-the-art national library of the country, where people who will be going to seek for information at that center will find it to be an experience to go to that library.
The plans that we have in the future for this institution is to make sure that at least every county has a library, every constituency have one or two libraries, wards have a small library, in fact, even every village to have a library.
I work hard so that in future I can be a lecturer. When I grow up, I would like to become an engineer.
There is a saying that goes, that a reader lives 1,000 lives before he dies. Kenyan National Library Service will continue to offer access to information and promote reading for knowledge, information, and enjoyment.
Education is the only thing that can really better your life.
It's only education we can make you think outside the box.
If you think books are expensive, then try knls.